I'm blessed. It's nice to see you this morning.
Nice to see you, Carlos. Amen. Amen. So amen. I usually ask, how did you find out about me?
Well, I've heard you've actually ministered to me a while back, I think last year, but I know about you through YouTube, and I went back on your YouTube channel, and I saw your new procedure, and I figured, you know what, I'll send her an email, and let's see what happens.
Okay, so Carlos, I mentioned you before. You said that was the first time I mentioned you for last year?
Yeah, I think it was last year. It was a while back.
Okay. Now, let me make sure I have the right person in mind here.
Yeah.
Were you the one who, the last time that I conferenced over email,
yeah,
you seemed to be a little upset in reference to your deliverance?
I'm not sure. The last time I think I got ministered was, I think, sometime like in September or August of 2016. It's been, or October, sometime around last year. It's been over a year.
Okay, well, good, that wasn't you.
Yeah, it wasn't me then.
Okay, I'm just trying to remember you. I mentioned so many people. It's difficult to remember them. But
oh, yeah, I can imagine.
Nevertheless, this is your first video.
Yeah.
Session, so
amen.
We'll continue on. So now what happened? Because I do know that God set captives free. When I remind him of his will to be done on earth as is in heaven.
Yes, it is.
So what did the Holy Spirit bring back to your remembrance as that open door, Carlos?
I think a lot of it was me going back into sin. You know, I'm a single man, and I struggle with, I'm a man, you know what I'm saying? You probably know what I'm saying, and
I want you to confess. Be specific, what you're struggling in. Don't hide it, because if you try to hide it, then that gives those devils to go anywhere.
Using drugs, and then I found myself getting involved in other sin, like watching videos I shouldn't be, and
porno.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, masturbation of that sort. And
so tell me now, which came first? Which one did you start after your deliverance?
It was probably, I think. And another thing I've been struggling with is the secular music, because another thing that I wanted to address was, I hear music constantly in my head where it's so bad that it brings confusion, forgetfulness, and lack of concentration. I can't even focus. I mean, it's so bad that it affects my daily life and my work. I can't concentrate. So there's a number of things that I'm struggling with, really.
Well, the thing is, Brother Carlos, is that Jesus, he freed you from all of that, okay? It's just that you gave in to temptation because you failed to continue to submit to God in obedience.
Yeah.
Now, do you have a bunch of fellows that you hang out with?
Not really. I'm more to myself. So I know people, but I don't really hang out with a lot of people. I'm more to myself.
Okay. So again, you said the porno came first when you started watching.
Probably the drugs and then the porno. So it kind of
comes. So the drugs. What type of drugs?
Crystal meth.
Crystal meth. Now, did you get rid of, after your deliverance, did you get rid of all of those things? Did you do a spiritual house cleaning to get
rid
of all of
them? Not on that. No,
that's
I
where
didn't.
You missed. Okay, that's where you messed up.
Yeah.
You have to get rid of those things, because if not, those things, demons are attached to them.
Yeah. And the music, I've been hearing the music for years, though. And I try to replace it with worship music, and sometimes that goes well, but then there you go again.
Because you had those evil things in your house.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, those.
Yeah.
So after your first deliverance, you still kept that, I don't know nothing about these things, but the thing to do crystal meth in, you had those things in the house.
Yeah.
See, demons were attached to those things. So what they was doing, they was enticing you.
Yeah.
They were beckoning you to come. They were using it to tempt you because of those evil things. You have to get rid of all of those things. And the thing that's so easily to beset you, we must get rid of it.
Yeah.
And so when you went back to it, then the devil that opened the door for other spirits to come in.
Yeah.
So right now, Carlos, do you still have no things in your house?
You talking about like physically in my house right now?
Yeah.
No.
So you did get rid of it. You got rid of them.
Yeah, I have some CDs, like some old CDs. I think in my mom's room, I can just throw those away. I mean, I don't even listen to them anyway. There's some music CDs, like rap mm-hmm. CDs.
Yeah, you get rid of those. And make,
I'll get rid of them.
Make sure you don't have no drugs. I can't pronounce that word. How you pronounce it? Infinario. How you pronounce it?
Paraphernalia?
Yeah, paraphernalia.
Yeah, paraphernalia.
Yeah, make sure you don't have none of that stuff in your house. You have to get rid of it because demons are attached to it.
Okay.
Okay. Now your camera, could you bring it down? Yeah, just a little more. There you are. Like for the person's face to be in the middle where I can see it.
Okay.
Now, as far as you're going to church, are you going to church?
Yeah, I'm going to church. Lately, I haven't been going because my work schedule. I've been working Sundays, but as far as my job, I've been actually going through some personal things with them, and I think God is kind of showing me you need to quit that job, and eventually, maybe tomorrow, I'm going to probably go back to church and start fellowshipping with the brothers.
Yeah, you're going to have to, because when we go fellowshipping one with another, it builds our strength in the Lord. It builds our trust, our faith in the Lord. It just encourages us. It helps us. But when we forsake ourselves with the symbol of our brothers and sisters, then that gives Satan leeway just to with the suggestions into our mind, and we'll give space to that. And next thing you know, you just start being depressed and doing things that you ain't got no business doing, and you get further and further away from God.
Yeah.
So fellowship with one another is very crucial.
I'm gonna start doing that.
It's crucial to our spiritual health. Okay.
Yep.
You hang around with brothers and sisters who like-minded in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
You know, now as far as you been married, I heard this so much. And I say it so much. So many times, you know, you just have to give God that care. Just cast it to him. You know, when you throw something at a person, to a person, you let it stay. You don't take it back. You know, you just.
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
You just have to be patient, and you have to
hard
be
hard sometimes.
Well, no, it's not hard. It's not hard. If it wasn't hard, the Lord would have told us to cast all our care upon him. Now, when the Lord tell you something hard to do?
No, Jesus, of course not.
Okay, so he told us to cast all our care upon him because he cares for us. You see, so if Jesus told us to do it, then that means we can do it. Hey, that means I can do it. He told me to do it. So it's not hard because he's not going to tell you to do anything hard, you see.
Yeah.
Now, you got to keep your eyes holy, you know. If you own your computer, your phone, or whatever, doing porno, you repent, ask the Lord to forgive you.
Yeah.
And you delete those links. Delete those links.
Yeah, totally.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And just stay in obedience to God. You know, our time on this earth, Carlos, is very short.
Oh, that's it's like Lord, a vapor. It's like a vapor.
That's why the Lord tells to redeem the time. You could be here 1 second, and next second you could be gone. So that means that, it's time to stop playing around. It's time to stop being careless. It's time to stop being foolish. We know the truth. You know the truth, you see. And when you know the truth and don't do it, it's going to be a greater punishment.
Yep.
You see, you know, whatever we need, all we have to do is just call on the Lord. Look at Joseph. You say you're a man. I know exactly what you mean because men have a tendency to say that. I think you all forget about Jesus Christ. He was on earth He came to earth as a man.
That's what my mom was telling me the other day. He was a man, and he didn't have sex.
You see, why? Because he always kept his father's mission in his heart and in his mind. He always focused on the father's will, not his will to be done, but the father's will. Now, he was tempted.
Oh, yeah. Of course he was.
And he was tempted as a man. He was not tempted as God. He was tempted as a man. But because he kept his mind and his heart stayed on his father's will, the father enabled him to endure and bear all things. Jesus is our example. Jesus is your example. You see?
Yep.
Now, it wasn't the father's will for him to continue on earth no more than 33 years and get married. That wasn't the father's will for him. You see?
No.
But the point of it is, you know, Jesus is your example. It's all our example. You know, he empowered us with his strength, like he empowered Joseph. Joseph did not trust his strength. That's why Joseph ran.
He ran from that woman.
You see, because he didn't trust his strength. He ran from that woman. And Jesus overpowered him. And at the Lord appointed time, he gave him a wife. You see? Yep. So your problem is you have a tendency to flip-flop. You take your mind off the Lord. You can't do that. Mm-hmm. You can't endure for a split second. I did not realize that I did it. And it was a split second. And the enemy swooped in. I'm like, I had to say, Jesus. I had to holler and call on Jesus. I didn't even realize that my mind had slipped off him. Just that quick. And the enemy was like standing there waiting. And I vividly, the Lord allowed that to let me see what happens when we take our mind off him. You can't keep your mind on Jesus 24/7. Yes, you can. You keep your mind on something 24/7. Yes, you can. That's why the Lord said, pray without ceasing. You are a spirit. You know, we have a soul, mind with emotion. We live in this body for this earth. Yes, it's dangerous when you take your mind off the Lord. Even a split second, Satan will jump right on in. And Carlos, God has forgiven you. Yep. And the Lord said, go. That means he has forgiven you too, but you sin no more. Yeah. He said, now if you sin again, a worse thing would happen. It's dangerous. I don't know if you remember Zachary Timms. You remember Zachary Timms?
You see
how they kept cut undercover for years and actually what happened to him?
I'm not sure what happened.
I know you don't, because they kept it hid for a few years. But you can't hide the truth. The truth comes out. And see, Second Tim never been delivered. He never been delivered from that spirit wife. So his wife divorced him because he was having affairs with prostitutes whenever he would travel to different places for ministry opportunities. Okay? So she divorced him. So in the public eye, they thought all was well. He hooked up with T.D. Jakes and no other big preacher. They thought all was well. One day he ministered, I think, in New York, and he went to the hotel room, and then on his way out, before he can get out, the man dropped dead. Young man dropped dead. Well, in the media, they said some drugs were on him. But the church people tried to deny it. And I asked the Lord what happened. He told me what happened. And finally it came out that he was in the hotel room with a prostitute.
Wow.
And doing cocaine drugs.
Wow.
And see, and here's a man that was going from city to city, state to state, and probably country, ministering the gospel, but living a double standard life.
Oh man, that's horrible.
The word of God say the soul that sins, it shall die. When you sin, Satan have legal right to kill you. I know the Holy Spirit warned Zachary many a time to stop his evil ways, but he didn't. So he didn't even make it out the door. Death came. And they did an autopsy. and the family requests not to be shared. They wanted to suppress it. But it won't probably about 2 or 3 years later that it came out that indeed the autopsy showed that he had drugs in his system. Wow. Because it was on his person and he was there with a prostitute. So here's a man of God that was going around whenever he would travel, having prostitutes and doing drugs. And you see when death came, and that's when that happened, Carlo, you cannot say that person went to heaven.
Oh, of course not.
Death came so quickly. He did not know. It came quickly. So God is warning you. Sin no more.
Yeah.
If you do, least a worse thing will come upon you. Remember the Lord telling that young man that?
Yeah.
It was a young man in scripture that was bedridden. I think he had some kind of sexual disease or something.
Yeah.
But the Lord told him to sin no more. Least a worse thing happen to you. So he's warning you to sin no more. Least the worst thing happen to you. Be obedient to him.
Amen.
Things the Holy Spirit revealed to you to get rid of, you get rid of it. People he revealed to you to not to connect with in relationship, you don't connect with them in relationship. You keep your mind stayed on the Lord. And then your heart will remain in perfect peace. That's why your heart's not in perfect peace, because your mind is not stayed on the Lord. Okay? Praise the living God. So God, he will do it again. You know, he will set us free again. We ask him. But the Lord is saying, let it stay this time. And how you let it stay, you be complete in obedience to God. Okay?
Amen.
Amen. So I'm going to pray for you, and I'm going to do a Holy Ghost fire cleansing prayer. It's a Holy Ghost fire cleansing prayer in which the Holy Spirit is the one who's going to clean you. Clean your mind. Your mind needs to be clean. Your will, your emotions, and your body needs to be clean. And it's only the Holy Ghost who can do that. So I just want you to be within yourself, be thanking God for forgiving you and thanking God for setting you totally free.
Amen.
So that you can truthfully, spiritually worship him. So that you can carry out the Father's will and plan and purpose in your life, which is to only bring glory to Jesus Christ. Okay?
Amen.
Amen. So, Father, in Jesus' name, we just, again, thank you for this opportunity that you have given us to come together in your Son, Jesus' name. Now, thank you, Father, as always, for your loving grace and mercy that you have given me to minister your grace to your dear children. Father, I thank you for what you're about to do to my dear brother, because it's his desire, Father, to spend the remaining of his years in worshiping, serving, and honoring you, Lord, in spirit and in truth. For that is your desire, because you're still seeking for true worshipers. True worshipers, those who worship you truthfully and spiritually. I ask you to continue to give my brother Carlos more revelation and understanding as to who he is in your Son, Jesus Christ, and also who Jesus is in him. Father, I just thank you. Thank you, Father, for opening doors. For the enemy have closed doors from Brother Carlos, and it's your will for those doors to be open. I take my thoughts in Jesus' name, and I open every door that is your will to be open. And also close those doors in which the enemy opened that was never your will or desire to be opened. I close those doors and seal those doors in and with the blood of Jesus, but they never be opened and or reopened again. Father, I thank you because you're faithful to your word. You told us to remind you of your word, and you are faithful to your word. We thank you, Father, that we are a people or a person that lives by faith alone in your word, not by what our eyes may see, or our ears may hear, our hands may touch, or our five senses, but we live by faith, and we're justified by faith. And I thank you for your presence, for you are truly with us right now, because you're in your word, you said that when we come together, rather there are two of us, and in your Son, Jesus Christ, name, that you are right here in the midst with us. And you also said, now this is your word, you said that whatever we bind and loose on this earth, that you will bind and loose in the heaven. For we realize our battle is not against flesh and blood. It's against spirits that we cannot see with our eyes. And that is why we cannot base things on what we see, because we can't see them. But Father, we believe your word. And I thank you. I thank you that you're going to set my brother totally free from the contaminants that re-enter into his mind, into his will, into emotions, and into his body. I thank you for the Holy Ghost who's going to clean him today so he can truthfully and spiritually worship and honor you. And I thank you, Father, that he shall be the man of God that you have called him to be. The plan, the purpose, and ideas that you have already preordained in his life before he was ever born and bringing glory to your son, Jesus Christ, they shall be fulfilled through him and by him. And I thank you, Father, for there are those who are waiting on the manifestation of your son, who is Brother Carlos, so that they too can be brought out of that darkness into the marvelous light. And I thank you, Father, for your will to be done in his life. Glory to your holy name. So, because of your word, Father, you said, whatever I bind and loose on this earth, you are bind and loose in the heaven. You just need to hear your word being decreed on this earth. And I thank you that I'm taking my authority in your son, Jesus' name. Okay. Spirit wife, you fooled them. Yeah, you fooled them. You used the drugs to bring him back to yourself. But he don't belong to you. He belongs to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You have no more legal right to hold on and claim him. For the blood of Jesus broken. The blood of Jesus broke that legal right. The blood of Jesus destroyed that legal right. And in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command you to cut him. You cut his mind. You loose his mind. The blood of Jesus commands you. Cut his mind. Cut his mind. You cut his mind. You cut his will. You loose his will. Pack your thing. Get his will. Cut his emotion. Loose his emotion. Cut. All of you, out of his emotion. Get out. For the blood of Jesus commands you. Get out of you. Get out of him. Never to return. And you cut out his body. Get out of your things and get out. Get out of his body. Out of his body. Holy Ghost fire, burn. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn all manner of darkness that dominate holding on to his mind, his will, his emotion, and his body. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn everything that's not of you. Burn everything that's not of you. Set them ablaze. Set them ablaze, Holy Ghost. Ransack his mind. Ransack his will. Ransack his emotion. Ransack his body. Burn! Burn all that's not of you, Holy Ghost. Burn all that's not of you. Burn his penis. Burn God that's living in his penis. Burn spirit wife that's living in his penis. Burn his rectum. Burn in his mouth, in his nose, in his eyes, in his ear, in his chest, in his throat, in his belly. Ransack his belly. Go deep down in his belly. Burn all of them up. Uproot, burn everything up. Every plant I have, I have not planted. Uproot it, Holy Ghost. Uproot it, Holy Ghost. Set them ablaze. Set them ablaze. Set them ablaze. Set them ablaze in Jesus' name. Burn every mark, every image that was made in and on his body. Set ablaze. Set ablaze. Set ablaze. Set ablaze, Holy Ghost, in Jesus' mighty name. In the spirit realm, I take God's scissors. I cut and detach his brother Carlos from the ungodly covenant of idolatry and family witchcraft. I detach him from that evil spirit marriage. I disconnect him from that evil spirit marriage. I disconnect him from that evil spirit wife. I disconnect him from evil spirit husband. I disconnect him from all those evil spirit children. I just couldn't have no evil, that entire evil spirit family, every relationship in the spirit realm I have the Father did not connect Carlos to. I disconnect because the blood of Jesus disconnect him and sets him totally free by his shed blood in Jesus' mighty name. Even in this natural realm relationship, my Father did not connect Carlos to. I disconnect him from no relationship because the blood of Jesus disconnects him and sets him totally free by his shed blood in Jesus' mighty name. Brother Carlos, from this day forward, you'll be totally free. Be totally free in your mind. Be free in your mind. Be free in your will. Be free in your emotion. Be free in your business. Be free in your dream. Be free in your vision. Be free in all your affairs. And be totally free in your body to serve and worship the Lord. Him only will you serve in spirit and truth. You'll be free in Jesus' mighty name. Be free. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for once again setting this captive totally free. Now, Father, I ask you to fill my brother to overflow with your spirit. He needs to be filled, Father. Fill his mind to overflow, his will to overflow, his emotions to overflow, his dreams, his vision, his business, and all his affairs to overflow with your spirit, and fill his body to overflow with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father.
Lord, thank you, Jesus.
For your loving grace and mercy,
thank you,
for
Lord.
Cleaning and setting this captive totally free. Thank you, Father, for dispatching your angels in the spirit realm, snatching and grabbing every spirit that was not of you and sending them where you desire to send them. Thank you, Father, for goodness and mercy of Father Carlos all the days of his life. Thank you for the angels' protection around him. Thank you, Father, for placing him a fire protected bubble of the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for opening up those doors, financial doors. Thank you, doors of marriage, Father. Thank you, Father, for he shall prosper. And I thank you, Father, for healing his body. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. And once again, Father, I also pray for my brother's hot Holy Ghost sick him. Go and seek and destroy darkness that is hoovering every corner, crack, and crevice of his house. Seek and destroy all their hiding places. Go in every room and every bedroom and destroy darkness. That who was around the bed, over, under the bed, the foot, the front, the foot of the bed, under the bed, the top of the bed, between the sheets and the mattress, and destroy darkness. Don't leave no space untouched. Go even outside the house. Destroy darkness. Who was around the house, under the house, over the house, even under the ground, under the house. Holy Ghost fire, destroy all covenant, remiss, and contract that was written his name, his family name, on top of the earth, under the earth, even in the waters. Destroy the objects that were thrown on top of the earth, buried under the earth, and thrown in the waters of his name, his family name. Destroy all those evil objects. Seek and destroy all those evil objects. Seek and destroy all those evil objects. Seek and destroy all those evil objects in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
For your love and grace and goodness. Thank you, Lord.
Thank
for
you,
taking
Lord.
Control. Amen. You know, you're special, Carlos, because in this session with you, I observed the Holy Ghost quickly took control of everything. He quickly.
Wow.
I didn't have to go through my normal routine and saying things. Because the Holy Ghost, I mean, just like the scripture said in Isaiah 59:19, Holy Ghost sick them. Yeah. So sick them is a connotation, which means to seek with the intent to destroy. So like a flood, think of a pent upstream. A pent upstream, all of a sudden, it get loose. Well, that water going to come rushing in, unstoppable. Well, that's what the Holy Ghost did to you. He came in mightily like a pit upstream. Holy Ghost sick him. And no devils had to go.
Man.
You need to thank God. Praise his holy name. Now he said, go, which is I forgive you. Sin no more. At least a worse thing happened. He set you totally free, Carlos. And how I know he set you free is my faith in his word. It's not based on that manifestation. You know what? You need to stop that. Stop looking at a manifestation as your evidence that you were set free or you were not set free. Okay. It's your faith. Yeah, it's your faith in God's word. Mm-hmm. He said, whatever you bind on earth
will be loosed in heaven.
I will bind in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth, I will loose in heaven. That is his word. So that's the basis. That is my proof, my evidence that people are set free. I don't have to see or hear a demon manifestation.
Yeah.
Satan will trick you and fool you by manifesting so that you would think that it left when it didn't.
Oh, okay.
You see? That's okay, why you can't go by your sight. You see what I'm saying?
Okay, I see what you're understanding now. I know what you're saying now. It makes sense.
You see? Yeah. So if you want to keep your deliverance, you say, Lord, I thank you because I'm free because I believe and trust in your word. Your servant remind you of your word. Whatever we bind and loose on earth, you will bind and loose in heaven. And on that basis, I believe. And Satan cannot take your deliverance, you see?
No.
He cannot take it. Now, there is time that God will allow demons to manifest like he did with you, and there's some sessions he will not. If you notice Jesus' ministry, when he cast out devils, he gave several examples. Some examples, the devils left quietly. Other examples,
they didn't say nothing.
They just left. They right. Yeah. Other examples, they pitched a fit before they left, you see.
Yeah, they complained.
They complained. So in either case, Jesus knew that they had to obey the word because he believed his father's word. Mm-hmm. But pastors today, like I got a comment on one of my posts on one of my sessions from this African pastor who said, sister, there's a much better way where you can see the demon leave when it leaves a person, when they manifest. I said, I removed that comment because the comment is a lie, it's misleading. Not only that, I blocked him because he only did that because he trying to get attention. Because he said, I'm a deliverance pastor myself and I deliver people and I'm blah, blah, blah. I said, you want attention, you're trying to use me to get followers. So I blocked him. I don't have such people. But he's misleading people. He's not teaching people to receive from God by faith. The word of God say, whatever is not of faith, Carlos,
it's sin.
It's sin. So if you go out telling people, well, I know I'm free because them demons manifested, them demons jumping right back into you because that is not faith.
Wow.
Faith in his word. You having faith in what you saw or what you heard. So that gets sin. That sin, Carlos, and so they coming right on back. You see?
That makes sense. No, I didn't understand that.
Yeah, it messing up a lot of people. The Lord told me to teach people this because a lot of ministers is not teaching people that. You know,
no, they're not.
They're teaching people that when they manifest, that means demon is leaving, and that's how you know you're free. No, dear Lord. I'm telling you, they will trick you. When the servant of God who trusts God's word command demons to come out of a person, they got to obey the word, obey God's servant because of his word, because of their faith in God's word. They're going to come out. Now, it's up to the person to maintain their deliverance. So what will happen is, if you don't believe by faith in God's word that he set you free, but you believe you're free because of that manifestation, when you go out that door away from the servant of God, them demons standing right out there, and they're going to jump right back into you.
Oh, yeah, totally.
That's sin. What you call parking lot demons. They parking lot demons. I'm kidding you not. I had that happen. This one girl, beautiful, delivered. God set her free. And lo and behold, services ended, and the girl was in the parking lot. And that devil whispered in her hearing, and she received it. She took the anointing water and threw the anointing water away and told her friend, I made a mistake. See how them demons in the parking lot waiting for her?
Wow.
Be careful, dear heart, a parking lot demons. You get delivered in the house of God. No demons right there in the parking lot waiting and looking to see if you receive what God was doing through the servant by faith. If you did not receive it by faith, they're giving the nigga right to hop right back into you. And then you go out and say, well, that didn't work. Oh, it always worked. It's just you. You fail to hold on to it only by having faith in God's word. God's word set you free, Brother Carlos.
Okay. Amen.
Now, when God delivered me, the demon did not manifest where the human eye can see it.
Yeah.
When God delivered me. But I do know I experienced that thing flying out my mouth, and my spirit immediately kept saying, thank you, Jesus, thank you, Jesus, thank you, Jesus. But if the people had to go by what they saw, they would say nothing happened to me when it did. So I'm telling you, Satan will get you. He'll trick you if you walk by your five senses. You'll miss your blessing.
Yeah, holy. By you faith.
Right. It's whatever we receive from God, we must receive by faith. You know, Scripture said when he comes back, he said, will I find it? He's looking. What are you looking for? He's looking for faith. Tenacious faith. Pastoring faith. Faith that didn't give up. Faith that didn't give in. So he said, will I find it? Because if you really notice, people are not walking by faith in God. No. We live by faith. The just shall live by faith. We serve in a God we cannot see. So we must serve him by faith. We must know who he is. He's not going to prove to us who he is so that we can believe him. We have to receive him first and believe him. And then he'll show us who he is.
You see? Amen.
Amen. So you are free. And I know because of the word of God. That's the reason why on this session, y'all may always hear me remind the Father of his word. Because that's the basis that I'm standing on. Whatsoever you bind loose on earth, I will bind loose in heaven. That's our legal right. And so I remind him. And on that basis, that ground, I know they leave. Most times there's no manifestation. Sometimes it don't matter. I know they leave. In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name. Amen,
Brother Carlos. It's done.
Amen.
Jesus' name. You enjoy your day, your night. And
thank you.
Give God praise and glory. And just
you too, Evangelist King. You too.
Continue to enjoy the blessing of the Lord. So just share with us right quick what you were experiencing.
Experience the power of God working. Other than the manifestation, I totally feel free in the will right now. Yeah, freedom. That's the word right now.
They had your mind and your will bound real tight.
Yeah.
That's the reason why they was able to use your emotions in your body. But the stronghold. Did you know it was spirit wife who came back?
No.
Yeah, spirit wife came back. It was spirit wife who came back. But had you thinking that devils enter because of the drugs? She used the drugs. She used the drugs so that it could create a door for it to come on back.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
That's why when the Lord through me began to talk to spirit wife, that's why that behavior came out.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They are so sneaky. They are cunning. And it only takes the Lord to let us know of their schemes and their tactics.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Praise the living God. You are totally free. God. Amen. Now, you go out and you share praise what great things God has done for you, Brother Carlos.
Done a lot.
Share it with your mother first. Share it with your mother first, okay?
I will. Definitely.
Amen. Continue to have a blessed day. In
too,
Jesus' mighty name. And you make sure you God gonna bless you with a job where you could be free to go to church. You attend church on Sunday, you'll be free to fellowship with like-minded believers so you can build your strength and trust in the Lord and in one another.
Amen, Evangelist King. Thank you.
Okay. You're welcome. All right then. Bye-bye.
All righty. You have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye.